Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We had two strong earthquakes on the 21st and 22nd, right around the new moon. As we anticipated in the previous update, the 6.5 magnitude earthquake occurred later on the 21st, right at the time of the new moon. 6.5 Hindu Kush region, Afghanistan, as you can see, and it was widely felt all the way down to New Delhi, India. And that happens with deep earthquakes, they can be felt over a wide area. There are also reports that this earthquake reached magnitude 7.7, especially in the media in Asian countries. That was certainly not the case. There was a body magnitude registered up to 7.2. The moment magnitude, the current estimate, is around magnitude 6.5. 24 hours later, also a magnitude 6.5 earthquake deep below Jujuy, Argentina, approximately at the same depth. And that happened after the Sun-Mercury-Jupiter conjunction. As we explained in the previous update, we had the new moon converging with a planetary conjunction, Sun-Mercury-Jupiter. And if we have a convergence like that, that makes things more critical. Another interesting observation is that there was a strong clustering of earthquakes in the high 5 magnitude range. I also explained in the previous update that from the 11th to the 20th, there were no earthquakes in the high 5 magnitude range. There was only one, and it was on the 12th, magnitude 5.7. But other than that, that particular magnitude range was absent. Until the 21st, within about 24 hours, we see a huge clustering of these earthquakes, including, of course, the strong earthquakes, magnitude 6.5. But we see a typical clustering of stronger earthquakes around the new moon in a convergence with the Sun-Mercury-Jupiter conjunction. Very interesting observation, and I want to stress here again, earthquakes rarely occur on average. Of course, the larger earthquakes, that is. They rarely occur on average. More often they occur in clusters, and this has everything to do with the dynamics of the solar system. Up until the 24th, we are dealing primarily with lunar geometry. We had a high lunar peak on the 22nd, and that is caused by the lunar conjunction with Jupiter. This can result in some stronger seismic activity, most likely around the 25th, early on the 25th. And it's also the time that there will be some critical planetary geometry on the 25th and 26th, and that could result in stronger seismic activity starting on the 26th. It may not be much, and then things become more critical, because on the 27th and 28th, we're going to have a clustering of planetary conjunctions. First on the 27th, early on the 27th, Sun-Mercury-Uranus, and that conjunction in itself is not really critical. However, 24 hours later, we have Earth, Mercury and Jupiter also in a conjunction, and that is going to be a critical one. And we can have a strong to major seismic event as a result that could be around the 29th, 30th, and it could be a higher 6, maybe even reach magnitude 7 in a worst case scenario. It very much depends on the condition of Earth's crust, how the seismic response will be. It is not a one-way process, so it is not like we have the dynamics of the solar system that determines the seismic activity on Earth. It is actually a two-way process. In order for a major earthquake to occur, there must be a larger fault section on the planet that has reached a critical amount of stress. If that is not the case, we can have a convergence of planetary conjunctions and we may only see some seismic increase. But with Earth, Mercury and Jupiter in a conjunction, there is a higher probability of a strong to major seismic event. And in this case, that is most likely to occur on the 29th, 30th, maybe later on the 28th already. Again, it very much depends on the condition of Earth's crust. Also on the 28th, converging with Earth-Mercury-Jupiter conjunction is a lunar conjunction with Mars, and that adds to the critical geometry around the 28th. So I believe we really should be on watch for strong to major seismic activity potentially to occur around the 29th, 30th. And then later on the 30th, almost on the 31st, Earth will also be in a conjunction with Venus and Uranus. That also doesn't necessarily result in a strong seismic event. It also depends on the position of the moon, but it comes just after the convergence of planetary lunar geometry on the 28th. First, it is important to see what is going to happen following the planetary geometry around the 28th and see what happens. before we can say anything significant about Earth, Venus, Uranus in a conjunction. Let's have a look at atmospheric fluctuations that we had in the last couple of days. I already shared some of them in the previous update, and I'm going to show you them again. On the 19th, we had two fluctuations over Central America, near Central America, and also at the Pacific Antarctic Ridge. Also on the 19th, further north, Alaska, and just east of Tonga, Fiji, that would be the Loyalty Islands, Vanuatu Islands region. Then on the 20th, that was a fluctuation that I estimated at the western part, or sorry, that's the eastern part of the Himalayan mountains. And it just preceded actually the strong earthquake on the other side of the Himalayan mountains in Hindu Kush region. But that fluctuation may actually still be significant in the coming days, especially towards the end of the month with the critical planetary geometry. And speaking of which, we have further fluctuations also over the West Pacific. And that happened actually 2 days ago on the 21st. And that could also become significant in the last couple of days of March. And then a significant fluctuation that was just north of Guerrero, Mexico, actually quite over the Gulf of California. And we picked up another fluctuation there this morning. So that could be a significant one, and we could see a size response as a result. It could be to the south, could also be a bit to the north. It's an approximation, and they're not always correct, but this could be a significant indication, especially for the last couple of days of March, because then we're going to have critical planetary geometry that could result in a strong to major seismic event. And if I would make an estimate for that region over north of Central America, maybe a little bit to the north, in that region approximately, it could result in a strong earthquake, maybe higher 6 magnitude. That's currently my estimate. But again, it could reach magnitude 7. I don't think a high 7, probably not, but around 7.0, borderline 7, is a possibility in the last couple of days of March. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.